something's about. What if it's in there?
Just go and see your son. Yeah, just a quickie, read these RSJs tomorrow morning. Delivery's coming in at 10:30, so I'll get Gary on the case. The crane's booked in for 11, so yeah, we're all on track. Okay, right, I'll speak to you then. Bye.
Are you sure?
He has a urine infection, but he should be absolutely fine.
Oh, well, thank goodness for that. Hey, you had us all over Twitter there, didn't you? The temperature of 39.6 on the moment just started going.
You were right to bring him in.
So can I take him home?
Get him out of here.
Oh,
hey. Make sure he finishes the course of antibiotics and keep up his fluid intake.
Go on, then. Are you going to Lenny?
There you go.
Here we go.
We're going home.
Gina. I'm sorry.
Your daddy, where have you been? We've been phoning you like Billy.
Yeah, I know.
So why didn't you answer?
Anyway, panic over. He's going to be absolutely fine, aren't you?
So where the hell have you been? Beth?
She's the one. They were both fantastic, but she's the one.
I didn't do anything.
She grabbed hold of him and belted him with a shoe, then got me bag back before he could run off. All in a matter of seconds. She deserves a silver cross. She should be doing your job.
Honestly, officer, I just did what anyone would have. Might have reacted a bit quicker than most, but gotta look out for the old folks, haven't you? Times like these.
Hey, less of the old, I'm only 68.
The country's in the toilet, you running wild in the street.
And who got a decent look at him?
I did. He was white. He was about 5'8" and a half. His tracksuit bottom sucks into his sock.
Oh, my grandson does that.
What are they frightened of? Mice?
I'm always telling him not to, but will he listen?
Will he, heck?
And he was wearing glasses.
Ah, that's to lull you into a false sense of security, as if there's never been a wrong on wearing gigs. Well, he didn't pull the wool over my eyes, officer, I'll tell you that much for nothing.
I've just won at the bingo, you see, so I would have lost a fortune. But more important than that, I've got my husband in here.
You what?
Oh, if they'd have stolen him, I don't know what would have done.
Your husband's in your handbag?
My late husband, Lawrence. That's his ashes.
Was he quite a little fellow?
Oh, the rest of him's in Windermere, where we had our honeymoon.
He was a bus driver. Oh, and by the way, we've already missed two buses talking to you, pair.
Well, in that case, who'd like a lift home?
All of us.
Yeah.
Fancy another?
I do, yeah.
I'm nipping to the toilet. I'll grab him on my way back. Same again, young man.
We should invite Jason tomorrow. You know, get it nipped in the bud.
Yeah, I'll ask him.
So, who else is coming?
Well, this lot, plus Michelle. Leanne said she's up for it. Mary. Oh, and Sally and her boyfriend.
Yeah, Sally, what can I get you?
All right, little glum, you do be looking.
I'll have a white wine, please. Oh, and whatever your mum wants as well.
Hey.
Yeah?
Hey, Mary, what are you two sneaks whispering about?
She thinks all of us have a Manchester.
What? No, we don't.
Oh. Thought you were going out with Deirdre.
Yeah, I was, and she cancelled, but the text didn't send.
Oh, all dressed up and nowhere to go, eh?
I didn't know you were coming in.
Oh, the day I've had, Liz. Jason and Tony had a falling out. And I wish I could say it was all Tony's fault, but it wasn't. Jason gave Tony a gobful. He went off with a flea in his ear. I don't know where he is now.
White wine.
Oh, are you two having a...
No, we're just having a drink.
Yeah, that's what I said. Why, what did you think?
What?
I'll leave you to it. Oh, by the way, Jason's at home licking his wounds. Glad to see you're equally devastated.
What have I done now?
I'm going to go and sit with Lloyd.
Oh, no, you don't have to do that.
Don't worry, I'll pick up the pieces. Always have done, always will.
Listen to you picking up the pieces. He's 28 years old.
He is 30.
Well, even more reason then. I came in here for a pint. What should I be doing? Writing him a letter of apology and making him a daisy chain? Unbelievable.
You all right?
Never goes away, does it?
What?
Any of it. Everything you've ever done, every mistake you've ever made.
Oh. All right, mate. League Cup, Okay. Would you fancy?
Penelope Cruz at the minute.
So is 18 a prime number or a composite number?
Faye, do you understand this?
I think so. We did it yesterday.
So is it?
I'm not sure.
Well, what's a prime number?
I think 18's a composite number.
Why, though?
I don't know.
Hey! Look who's here!
Oh, so he's all right, then?
Yeah, he's gonna be fine. Just had a little infection.
What did I tell you?
Yeah, surety.
Yeah, we're just onto our own work now. Do you know what a prime number is?
Oh, I haven't got a jar of glue.
I think it's something to do with what it can be divided by.
I know what a primary colour is. It's red and yellow and blue.
Izzy, do you know what a prime number is?
No. Oh, but I could do with a
Not
drink.
Not much help these, are they? Right. It says here, a prime number is something that can be divided by 1 or itself, for example, 7 or 13. So, what about 18?
18 can be divided by all sorts. Mm. 1, 2, 3, not 4. Not 5, 6, 9, and itself.
Is he all right, then?
Yeah, it's nothing serious, he said, but we were right to take him in.
Right, come on, let's get back to the site, guys. We didn't lock up properly.
Hey, you're not going now, are you? Katie, have we still got that bottle of cava in the fridge?
Yeah, why are we cracking it open?
You're too right, we are. Little Mike's good as new.
Well, it's still not well, but we can drink in a bit more, can't we?
How's it feel to you, Gary?
What?
You all right?
Yeah, I'm fine.
Hey, hello, Hannah. Oh, shh.
I was right to lay into him. You change your tune.
All I'm saying is that you might have a point. That's all. Maybe he doesn't care quite as much as he makes out.
Why? What's happened?
Nothing. It's just you don't have to seek his approval.
I didn't, and I'm never going to, right? What?
Of course you seek his approval.
No, I don't.
That's why you're upset about Dev's contract, because you don't want your dad to think you're not the man.
Anyway, if I do go through with the pointing, you can do it on your own.
It doesn't need repointing. You might as well be wearing Spurs and a Stetson.
Well, if you ask me, the man's a waste of space. I don't think he'll be troubling you again, though, Jace, or coming back round here.
Good.
Right, I'm going for a bath. Does anybody want the toilet? Hmm?
No. Hey, Jace, fancy a drop of something stronger?
There's a police car outside.
What?
Just pulled up.
Where?
Look, have you never seen a police car before?
Good night, officers. Thanks again for the ride.
Bye. Take care. Fancy that. What a night.
Might not have been a pink hummer, Auntie Beth, but it was an adventure.
Well, it plush in there.
No, I've never been in one.
I should hope not at all.
Did we just see you two getting out of that cop car?
Let's go inside and I'll tell you all about it.
Are you in trouble?
No. Trouble? She is a heroine.
She's on heroin?
What did it have to do with her anyway? We're only having a drink. We're both single.
People are funny.
Eileen isn't.
Hey, she is my mate, you know.
What did I tell you, though? Exes, albatrosses, all of them.
You had a kid with her? What do you expect? It is really hard bringing up kids on your own. You can't blame her for resenting you.
I was there when he was little.
Oh.
Now and again.
You took a wild guess at his age and you were 2 years out.
I know how old he is. I was pushing the buttons.
Well, do you know what? You're even worse than I thought.
I can't do anything right today. What, are you really starting on me as well?
Maybe I should go behind the bar.
No. No, when you've gone to all that effort, no.
I wonder, do you think she still likes you?
Eileen, she isn't stupid.
Does that mean she does or she doesn't?
I should have left them all to it. A phone call from Jason once a year. I should have settled for that.
Not much, though, is it?
You just got the one?
Two. Other ones in Spain. The twins.
Which do you like best?
Varies from day to day.
Is that Eileen's ex?
Yeah, but she can't stand him.
Didn't look that way to me.
Should your mum even be, well, you know?
It's a tricky one, that, isn't it? Dating your mate's ex. It's usually a no-no. We'd have to check the manual.
I'd love to have a look at this manual.
Oh, would I?
It's at a big 5-0, huh? Halfway to 100.
You never think you're going to reach 50, do you?
Hey, you never think you're going to reach 30. Then before you know it, your kids are 30. I mean, how does that happen?
You know, it's just like a relentless
He look good on it, though, doesn't he? Huh?
Yeah, he looks good. Very good.
Thank you.
Take Izzy and the kid home, then come back for me.
What are you thinking?
Well, I'm thinking that no news is good news, as far as I'm concerned.
You said nothing to her?
Hang on, let me try again. Like what? How can I? Just try and not relax, will you? The last thing we want is them not getting suspicious.
Dad, Anna wants to know when you're coming in.
We'll be there in a jiffy.
How long's a jiffy?
Good question, love. However, I am on the phone here. Let's go straight to answer the phone.
You know, I can't help thinking he'd let us know.
Let us know what?
That he's alive. And I'm dead. Right, we best get off here and put him to bed.
Are you not having a drink, Gary?
No, I'm driving.
Well, why don't you leave JK tonight? I'll look after him, then you can have a drink and relax.
No, honestly, we've got to get off. We have to get over to the site.
How was it today?
Well, fairly uneventful.
So much of you know who?
A bit, earlier. What about you, Gary?
No, not much today.
Lucky you.
Oh, I saw him today, throwing his weight around as usual.
Yeah, well, I'll be glad when the money's in our pockets.
Well, it's a while yet, love.
Cheers!
Cheers!
To Jake. And to being rich.
Oh, I'll drink to that.
Yeah, me too. Cheers, love.
Cheers, love.
Then she hit him with a shoe, grabbed the bag and chased him halfway down the road.
Honestly, can we stop talking about it now? It was nothing.
It was not nothing. This old woman kept her husband in her handbag.
Her husband? In her handbag?
Well, how big was it?
It's ashes, you donut, in a little urn.
So, if she hadn't have done what she did, that woman would have never seen him again, in a manner of speaking. And not only did she have him in there, she also had the winnings.
She just won at the bingo.
What a night.
How come you hit him with your shoe?
It was the nearest thing to hand. I was holding it.
Why were you holding your shoe?
She was rubbing her foot.
Why was you rubbing your foot?
Oh, flaming hell! I had a blister. I single-handedly catch a robber, and all you want to know about is me foot. I was trying to make the bus come faster, if you must know.
What?
Hey, shall I warm you up that bit of stew?
Hey, now you're talking.
Actually, that might prove tricky.
You didn't.
He didn't.
So who did?
Hello.
Can't he just lock up on his own? I don't see why it takes two of you.
Yeah, but we've got some other stuff to catch up on for tomorrow. 30 RSJ's coming.
How come I couldn't get hold of you tonight? I tried you loads of times. My dad wouldn't pick up at first either. You seem cagey.
Yeah, well, wouldn't you be? Yeah, I've just found out through your dad that Jake was in hospital.
Well, that's all done with now.
Sorry, it's just this job. I'm not even sure I'm up to it.
Of course you're up to it. You just don't like feeling, that's all. And who can blame you? You didn't say that to your mum, did you?
No. I don't intend to. I just want to stay well out of his way.
Yeah, listen to this. I buy Michelle a present yesterday.
What'd you buy her?
Well, nothing special. It was a docking station for her iPod. It was cheap and she didn't like it. It was the wrong colour. Anyway, that's by the by. Point is, on the back of me buying her this present, we have a massive argument because I never buy her presents.
Oh, man, that's rough, though, isn't it?
I mean, I said, look, I'm buying you a present. That is a present. Now, that just showed her what a rarity it was.
I'm in a lose-lose situation, mate.
There's a moral in it somewhere.
Don't buy them presents.
Buy her more presents, you dimwits. You can't see the moral in that story. You're dafter than you look. And you haven't bought me a present yet.
Yeah, and you haven't bought me one either. See, it's a two-way thing.
Oh, you see, I should have thought of that. Michelle never buys me presents either.
Always think of clever things to say after the event. Wouldn't it be good if you could go back in time?
How far back would you go?
Oh, I'd go all the way back to infant school, me.
Oh, thanks.
Right, I'm going into town.
With them?
No lock-ins.
See you later.
Watch your purse.
Why should she?
Where do you think?
Why don't we let bygones be bygones?
Come on, Tom, let's go.
Hey, where do you stand on buying women presents?
Well, I used to buy my wife something every week.
Every week?
Well, usually just small things. You know, something I'd see that reminded me of her. A pair of earrings, maybe, or if, you know, I'd notice she'd turn the corner of a page over in a magazine, I'd write down what she was looking at and
or whether it be perfume or shoes, I'd surprise her. What do you take me for? Birthdays and Christmases, and that's it.
Oh, don't do that to us again.
Time to skedaddle. I will see you tomorrow at Steps.
See you, love.
Nice boy.
Yeah.
You know, to be honest, I think he's like a little in awe of me.
Well, why wouldn't he be, Dev?
It's nothing serious, that's the main thing, eh?
Doesn't have to give you a fright, though, when the temperature spikes like that. Just praying it wasn't meningitis.
Oh, human nature's thinking the worst, love. Especially when it's somebody you love.
Yeah.
So if the doctor says he's okay, then he's okay.
Is 953 a prime number?
You were late.
Well, you know, we're running a million-pound operation. Not building sandcastles, are we? What about you?
I'm fine.
Good.
Is 953 a prime number?
I don't know.
Faith, 5 to 10. Shouldn't you be in bed, love?
Yeah, come on, darling. You should go up now.
I'll check this, it's Gary.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah, I'll be outside in a minute. He's on his way around.
I don't see why you both have to go.
Oh, no, he wants to talk about one or two things for tomorrow. We've got a load of RSJs coming in and he's in charge.
Okay, well, don't pile too much on him, will you? Because he talks a good talk, does our Gary? But you know what he's like, he's a worrier.
No, he'll be fine. All right, I'll see you later. Yeah.
Be careful.
Yeah. Night, Faye.
That hit the spot.
I'm sorry, it wasn't much.
I wish I could cook like that.
Did you see how long it took her? A feast.
I wish I could do what you did. Dead proud of you, Auntie Beth.
Can that please be the final word on it? It's embarrassing. You act on instinct. What else can you do?
Hey, our Craig's got a bit of news and all. Haven't you, Craig?
No, I haven't. Shut up.
He was only on the phone to a girl this afternoon.
Was he?
Craig. What?
Who was she, Craig?
It was only about this week's physics homework.
Are you sure it wasn't about biology?
No, it's definitely physics, because I heard him.
Well, you shouldn't have been listening then.
Oh, so it wasn't just about homework.
It was, I swear. I don't fancy her.
I never said you did.
Who wants a bit of pudding? I bet there's some ice cream in the freezer.
Forget the ice cream. Why don't we go for last hour in Rovers?
I might hit the A.
You'll sleep better.
What about Craig?
He'll be all right.
He wants to make another phone call.
No, I don't.
I don't know.
Cheers.
What are we doing here, Jace? We've got a combined age of nearly 60 and we're still living at home.
Yeah, nothing's private in this house. That's the problem.
Yeah, I know. Not that job at the gym. What's it got to do with her?
Point in. Give me a break. He's trouble.
Just wants an excuse to stick around because he loves you.
Oh, shut up.
Yes, he does.
You've been putting too much whiskey in that glass.
Life's too short for holding grudges, Jace.
Go on, set the kettle on, eh, Todd?
You stick the kettle
it's
on.
It's your turn.
You know, Mum thinks I'm trouble, and I don't know why.
Yeah, you're all right. In small doses.
I've missed you too. Oh.
50 yards, I've chased him. You should have seen the fear in his eyes. I would have sat him till the Rozzers come, but we had to make sure Maureen was okay.
Who's Maureen?
Keep up. She's the woman whose bag it was. She was shaking like a leaf, wasn't she, Sinead?
I wasn't all.
But you're a proud man, Kirky.
Hey, damn right.
Anyone right for another drink?
She was a widow, this woman. Her husband was tragically taken from her. He was the love of her life.
He was nearly taken from her again as well. She only kept his ashes in her bag.
That's what I'm most proud of, I suppose. I can't stand the thought of her losing him like that. or what was left of him. Half of him's up in Windermere where they had their honeymoon. They were happier times for Maureen. When you could walk the streets without fear. When there was no such thing as tucking your tracky bottoms into your socks. When you could leave your back door open day and night. Get yourself a bag of chips and still have change for the bus home.
All she needs is a cape and a mask. The chief of police should have a phone on his desk with a hotline through to you. Or they could shine a searchlight in the sky.
Stop it with your searchlights and your hotlines. Brave? Yes. Superhero? Nah. Did you mention another drink, Steve?
Maybe she's taking him to the hospital. Or if not to the police. Maybe she's down the morgue identifying her.
Please stop saying that.
Then what's going on there?
No idea, Gary, but one thing's for certain. We'll find out pretty soon.
Everyone's favourite telly duo are joined by fellow Geordie Sarah Millican tomorrow at 7 when the comedian's guest announcer on Saturday Night Takeaway. And there's more comedy coming up next on ITV as our brand new show, Edge of Heaven, continues.